At the very threshold of civilization, where the fabric of reality was woven from the threads of forgotten truths and the divine intertwined indistinguishably with the mortal realm, the earth bore witness to the emergence of beings whose very existence challenged the confines of human comprehension. Among these enigmatic figures loomed the giants, heralded as the Nephilim, the offspring of a condemned union between the sons of God and the daughters of men. The ancient texts whisper to us from the past. In those days, and also afterwards, there were giants on the earth when the sons of God came in unto the daughters of men, and they bare children to them. They were the mighty men of old, men of renown. This prologue to our existence sets the stage for a journey into the depths of the unknown, inviting us to unravel the tapestry of our beginnings and the mysteries that have perplexed scholars, theologians, and seekers of truth through the ages. The legacy of the Nephilim, veiled in the mists of time, beckons us to explore the intersection of myth and reality, to decipher the codes of the divine that have been etched into the annals of history. So, prepare yourself as we delve into secrets and prophecies with contemporary analysis from start to finish. Stay with us and discover the divine mystery that awaits you. This introduction to the Nephilim leads us to the saga of Goliath from Gath, an imposing figure whose presence dominated the battlefield, evoking fear and admiration in equal measure. His story, immortalized in 1 Samuel 17, highlights not just his stature and strength, but also the epic confrontation with young David, who challenged and defeated the giant, changing the course of Israel's history. A champion named Goliath, from Gath, came out of the Philistine camp. He was 6 cubits and a span tall. He wore a bronze helmet on his head and was dressed in a coat of scale armor of bronze, weighing 5,000 shekels. On his legs were bronze greaves, and a bronze javelin was slung on his back. The shaft of his spear was like a weaver's rod, and its iron point weighed 600 shekels. His shield-bearer went ahead of him. Goliath's story serves as a prelude to the revelation of a lineage of giants, suggesting that the history of the Nephilim and their descendants was far from ending with his death. The chronicles of 2 Samuel 21:15-22 and 1 Chronicles 24:8 unfold in accounts of subsequent battles where the warriors of Israel faced other giants, heirs of the same mysterious lineage. These confrontations not only testify to the persistence of giants through the generations, but also highlight the continuity of the struggle between the divine, manifested by the fate of Israel, and the remnants of a world that preceded the order established by the flood. In this context, Goliath transcends the role of a mere antagonist. He represents the last of an era where Nephilim walked openly among men, challenging God's chosen ones and testing the faith and courage of mortals. His defeat at the hands of David is not just a military triumph, but a symbolic act, marking the beginning of a new era in which the descendants of Abraham would solidify their place in the promised land, free from the shadows of the giants of the past. After the fall of Goliath, the land of Canaan remained steeped in tension and mystery. It was not just the memory of the giant of Gath that haunted the valleys and mountains. His brothers, each bearing the same imposing lineage of the Nephilim, emerged from the shadows, ready to claim vengeance and perpetuate the legacy of their monumental existence. The sacred scriptures lead us through subsequent episodes, where the fate of these giants intertwines with that of the people of Israel in battles that would test the mettle of both. In 2 Samuel 21:15-22, we are introduced to these confrontations, narrating not just the valor of the Israelite warriors, but also the tenacity of the giants they faced. Once again, there was a battle with the Philistines, at Gob, where Elhanan, son of Jaare-Oregim, a Bethlehemite, killed Goliath the Gittite, whose spear shaft was like a weaver's rod. This account, echoing David's deed, symbolizes the ongoing struggle against the forces that challenged the sovereignty and divine destiny of Israel. 1 Chronicles 20-4:8, expands this narrative, detailing the victories over these formidable beings. And it came to pass after this, that there arose war at Gezer with the Philistines. Then Sibachai the Hushathite slew Sipai. That was of the children of the giants, and they were subdued. Each name mentioned, each giant defeated, was not just a mark in the chronicle of Israel's wars, but an affirmation of the fulfillment of the divine promise, a testament to the protection and power bestowed upon the descendants of Abraham. These battles, interwoven with heroism and tragedy, not only shaped the destiny of Israel, but also sealed the twilight of the giants on the land. The saga of Goliath's brothers and their clash with the Titans offers a window into an era when the extraordinary and the supernatural were part of the everyday, where the line between history and legend was as thin as the mist at dawn. However, these accounts go beyond mere documentation of ancient conflicts. They speak of courage in the face of the unimaginable, of the struggle for faith and the right to the promised land. The giants of Canaan, descendants of the Nephilim, serve as somber reminders of a past where heaven and earth were more intimately connected, and where beings of unfathomable power walked among mortals. Therefore, the defeat of Goliath's brothers was not just the end of a feared lineage, it was the continuation of a divine process, the transformation of the known world, and the affirmation of the people of Israel as bearers of the divine promise. In each fallen giant, the light of a greater purpose was reflected, the echo of a promise fulfilled, and the hope of a future forged in faith and determination. As the people of Israel consolidated their territory, facing and overcoming the giants that inhabited the promised land, a new chapter unfolded, one that would lead the descendants of Abraham and scholars of the scriptures to ponder the depths of divine mysteries. The question of the persistence of the Nephilim, those beings of enigmatic origin, continued to provoke reflections on the purpose and order of the post-diluvian world. The biblical narrative, rich in symbols and lessons, points to a period after the flood when humanity was meant to start anew, free from the corruption that had consumed it. However, the mention of giants, descendants of the Nephilim, in lands Israel aspired to call home, suggests a continuity of divine and earthly challenges, a plot where the past and present intertwine in unexpected ways. In those days, and also afterwards, there were giants on the earth, Genesis 6:4 reports, hinting that the presence of these beings was not limited to an era before the flood. Their survival or reappearance raises questions about the mechanisms of creation, divine justice and mercy. How could these beings persist or return in a world that had been purified by divine wrath? The answer perhaps lies not in the literalness of the texts, but in the symbolism and lessons they carry. Israel's journey, marked by encounters with giants in Canaan, reflects an ongoing struggle between the divinely established order and the forces of chaos remaining from the ancient world. Each confrontation, each victory, was not just an act of territorial conquest, but also an affirmation of God's sovereignty and the destiny chosen for his people. The giants, in this context, serve as final tests, challenges to be overcome by the heirs of the promise made to Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. This chapter of history not only narrates the struggle for the promised land, but also weaves a broader reflection on human nature, divine sovereignty, and the complexity of God's plan for creation. The persistence of the Nephilim, directly or symbolically, reminds us that the world is full of unresolved mysteries, questions that challenge our understanding, and truths that are beyond the reach of our limited vision. Thus, in contemplating the heritage of the Nephilim and the saga of the giants faced by Israel, we are invited to reflect on the continuity of divine influence in human history, the battles we fight, and the promises we seek to fulfill. we are reminded that, in every era, we face our own giants, challenges that require faith, courage, and the constant pursuit of a deeper understanding of divine purposes. As the sands of time continued to accumulate, concealing the foundations of ancient civilizations and their stories, the legacy of the Nephilim, those beings of mythological proportions and powers, persistently lingered at the threshold of collective consciousness. This legacy does not manifest through sightings of giants walking among us, but rather in the way these ancient figures have shaped human narratives, inspiring myths, legends, and even influencing spiritual and cultural beliefs across the ages. The curiosity about these beings, whose origins intertwine with the divine and the human, transcended the biblical narrative, finding space in the oral and written traditions of many cultures around the world. Stories of giants dwell in the folklore of distant peoples, suggesting a shared collective memory of a time when heaven and earth were not as separated as they are now. In the modern era, the quest for knowledge about the Nephilim has taken new forms, driven by both scientific curiosity and spiritual pursuit. Archaeologists, theologians, and mystery enthusiasts scour the scriptures, excavate ancient ruins, and examine relics in search of traces of these beings. Each discovery, each ancient text or mysterious artifact serves as a piece of an immense puzzle, an effort to understand not just who the Nephilim were, but also what their role is in the grand scheme of human and divine existence. The possibility that descendants or influences of the Nephilim persist to this day invites us to view our world in a new light. It can be argued that today's giants are not measured by physical stature, but by the impact of their actions, ideas, and innovations. Leaders, thinkers, and creators who shape the course of human history and whose achievements seem to defy the bounds of the possible can be seen as the Nephilim of our era, bearers of a spark of transcendence that defies conventional explanation. This contemporary look at the Nephilim reminds us that the past, however distant it may seem, continues to influence the present in unexpected ways. The questions raised by the existence and legacy of these ancient beings, about the nature of humanity, the possibility of the divine, and the quest for meaning in a vast and often incomprehensible universe, remain as relevant now as they were millennia ago. Thus, as we advance in the trajectory of civilization, we carry with us the shadows of the Nephilim, a constant reminder that the world is more mysterious and wonderful than we can imagine. They invite us to continue exploring, questioning, and seeking, not just to unravel the mysteries of the past, but also to understand our place and purpose in a cosmos filled with wonders yet to be discovered. The saga of the Nephilim, from their origins in ancient pages to their insinuated presence in the shadows of modernity, serves as a mirror to the deepest questions of the human soul. These giants of the past, beings born from the union between the celestial and the terrestrial, symbolize the eternal interweaving of the physical with the spiritual, challenging us to question not only the origins of humanity, but also the purpose and destiny of our journey. In our era, characterized by both technological advancements and spiritual quests, the Nephilim remain relevant as metaphors for the challenges we face. They remind us that, no matter how much we unravel the mysteries of the cosmos or reach new heights of understanding, there will always be unanswered questions, unexplored territories of existence awaiting our inquiry. The influence of the Nephilim extends beyond the realm of the mythological, touching the core of our struggle to comprehend humanity's place in the universe. Every discovery we make, every boundary we cross, reflects the duality encapsulated in the story of the Nephilim. The tension between our earthly origins and our celestial aspirations, between what we know and what eternally eludes us. As we conclude this exploration of the Nephilim and their legacy, we are left with a sense of humility in the face of the vastness of the unknown, as well as a renewed passion for the pursuit of knowledge. The story of the Nephilim, in all its complexity and ambiguity, is not just an ancient curiosity, it is an invitation to reflect on our own nature, on the many layers of reality that exist beyond everyday perception. Thus, in reflecting on the Nephilim, we are not merely looking back at the giants of an ancient world, we are also looking inward, questioning our own essence, and looking forward toward the uncertain future we all share. This journey of discovery, inspired by beings that inhabit the borders of myth and history, is a testament to the unextinguishable human desire to understand the universe and our place within it. Subscribe and illuminate our path with your like. Activate the bell to be the first to unravel these ancient mysteries with us and share your insights. Every comment of yours is a step forward on our journey. Remember, at every corner of the unknown, a new secret awaits you.